Hey, it's Punky J. What's going on, guys? Want to go ahead and do a band review. Had a request for it from one of my awesome fans, and so let's just go ahead and get to it. So basically, Demon Hunter, if you guys don't know, is a Christian metal band. They've been around since, I think, 2004, so about a good 12 years now. They haven't made an album in a while. I know the lead singer has done a bunch of side projects. One's called Knives. It's like this weird electronica kind of, I don't know, kind of Nine Inch Nails sounding band. There's a name for it. I just forgot. What's the genre of stuff like that? Industrial, I think. Did not care for it at all. And then he made another side project, which I don't know the name of, but he actually called it a goth band, which I thought was slightly humorous, because, I mean, goth has not been relevant in years, and it's not to say that he couldn't do it, but I don't know, man. I just thought it was kind of strange on his behalf. But anyways, getting back to the band, Demon Hunter, I think they're an exceptional band, especially for heavy metal, because it's metal with a message. It's not just growling and, you know, screaming and blast beats on the drums. It's more to it than that. You know, you don't have to be a metalhead to like their music, and that's what's so great about it. They are still brutal. They have some brutal songs, you know. They're labeled metalcore, but I don't think they're just limited to that. They have more of a thrashy kind of sound too. But yeah, I like a lot of their excuse me. Whew. I like a lot of their ballads. Carry Me Down, Thorns, The Tide Began to Rise, Dead Flowers. They have a lot of amazing slow song ballads, and you can tell the lead singer puts a lot of passion into what he does. But if I had to say this, it would be, I think there's actually better Christian metal bands out today than secular. It's because they have that metal with a message kind of thing to it, and they don't preach a lot either. That's what's so cool. It's like, you don't have to be a Christian to even listen to it. I mean, sure, that would probably help, and they do have some symbolic gestures to their faith and everything, but it's still, it's not just like, you know, it's not worship songs. It's just everyday songs, you know, songs about different stuff, personal issues that we all face, and that's what's so great about it. I do have a few gripes about the band, okay, that I'm, hope this doesn't offend anybody, but I met the lead singer, and he's kind of a douchebag. I don't know what his problem was, or if he was just having a bad day, but yeah, the lead singer, Ryan Clark, he's kind of a cunt, I have to be honest. I don't know why that is. I mean, he's in a Christian band, but it's just, I know things about him that I'm not crazy about. Like, I know he likes indie music bands like Radiohead and shit like that, which is beyond me. I don't know why, being a metalhead, he would like stuff like that. He made a comment, too, in one of his videos that, like, he doesn't like to eat meat with the bone on it because he feels it's barbaric. And I just thought that was kind of... I'm sorry. I just thought that was a little bit feminine, but, you know, the guy's talented. I mean, I would label him a musical genius, so I can't sit here on hate on the guy that much, but, oh, poor Ryan Clark. I think he probably hangs out with too many hipsters or something. I don't know, man. I mean, he's got the beard, too, but he's got the cool metal beard. It's not like the hipster beard really isn't that different from the metal beard, I guess, to be quite honest. But anyways, I think it's stupid too that Ryan Clark, the singer, he doesn't believe that you can mix electronica and metal, and I think that's bullshit, because I don't think music is supposed to have rules to begin with, and he said himself that doing so is like making metal with a crayon or some stupid bullshit like that, even though there's some awesome dark dubstep out there that does not sound poppy at all. You know, the guy's a little bit older. I think he's in his late 30s. And so when you're an older metalhead, it just kind of makes you a little bit close-minded to certain things. But, I mean, other than that, I don't have problems with the guy. I just think he's kind of close-minded. And he's a little bit on the emo, indie side. But other than that, though, I really love Demon Hunter. And again, I don't know what happened the day I met him. Maybe he was just having a bad day or something. I don't know. But I don't really, you know, I'm not the type of person to hold grudges anyways. It's no big deal. You know what I mean? They still put on a damn good show. It was worth like the, I think I paid $20 for the ticket, $15. It wasn't, you know, it was a good price for the ticket. Wasn't a stupid, you know, fucking $100, you know, fucking shit that bands like Metallica would charge. It's funny, too, because there weren't a whole lot of people, so it was kind of more personal. It was, I would say, maybe like 50 people tops at the concert. Not even really a concert, I guess a show. It was at this place called, what is it? It's, here in Houston. It's been around forever. It's called Fitzgerald's. A lot of old school punk bands actually used to play there. It's kind of like a, I guess you could call it a venue, although it's not that big, you know. So it's not like super big bands would play there. But anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed my review. Shout out to Red Crimson Eye. I really seem like a really cool dude, man. I hope you keep following me. Anyways, yeah, guys, take care, and I'll see you next time. Peace.